funny because I feel like cozy and warm and happy, kind of like a turtle. And then I look in the mirror and I'm like, oh, I'm actually terrified.
What happened?
My wife.
She's alive. Vought's holding her captive somewhere.
And right now, we're in a little bit of trouble.
Absolutely loving both seasons of The Boys. Obviously, Black Noir is a character who's had lots of different reactions from fans over the last two seasons. How do you feel about him now after two seasons of playing him?
I love where we're going with Noir and, you know, what we've gotten to show the fans. You know, the balance of quirky, awkward things mixed with ruthless ninja-style killing. I think it's a really fun contrast to play with.
Originally, how did you audition for the role? Because this isn't any ordinary, like, character. How did you audition to play him?
Actually, I did an A-Train scene and a Deep scene. The way I approached it was I knew that A-Train and Deep were already cast. But I tried to imagine, okay, like, who would A-Train be? Who would the Deep be? And how can I bring someone to life that would complement and contrast them and do that in the scene? So, like, bring a little bit of what I thought A-Train would be, but also bring a little bit of, like, my own character. And then to physicalize my reactions and my expressions in that audition. You know, so I brought a heightened physical dimension to the audition, in addition to kind of trying to offer this third character that I knew would exist alongside those two.
We've obviously seen the infamous episode 7 and the nut allergy. I was reading how that was inspired by your own allergy. How did you feel when they put that into the script and slipped that in?
It was pretty funny. It was pretty funny. You know, it arose because I was telling a flight attendant that I had a nut allergy on our way to Comic-Con. And Carl was like, oh, what would happen if you actually had a reaction? And I was like, well, you know, I'd have some anaphylactic shock and, you know, react. It wouldn't be fun. And he's like, oh, that's interesting. I think I'll pitch that to Eric. And it was funny because on the plane ride over, somebody didn't hear the flight attendant. So somebody was eating nuts. And it was, by the time I found out who it was and I was able to ask them to stop, it was in the air. So I was just kind of covering my nose with my shirt, and I was sitting right beside Laz, and he would look over occasionally. And when we landed, I got up and I'm like, thank God, like I could breathe. And he's like, oh, what? I'm like, somebody, there was nuts in the air. And he's like, oh, I thought that was me. I thought I was like smelling or something, right? And I was like, no, it wasn't you. Yeah, it's fun. It's this fun, interesting art imitates life moment. It's also like a little edgy because it's a personal thing. You know, I've seen some fan art and I'm like, ah, I almost can't share this because it's too real. But it's cool. And, you know, allergies are a really common thing and a serious thing that does affect people. But we don't often see that in superhero stories. So it's nice to give that bit of representation of people.
You've obviously worn that suit now for two seasons. How are you, has it got any more comfortable? Is it nice to wear? How do you feel about it?
They're making the suit from the outside, but only we can tell them how it feels for us. And the dynamic of superhero suits in general is they look good, but the better they look, you know, the harder they are to wear in a lot of times. And, you know, our super suit team, like LJ and, you know, our super suit people on set and everything, they've done this really good job adapting to what we need. And so as time has gone on, you know, with the feedback we can give them, like, okay, there's a little bit of too much pressure here. My back is, you know, feeling this weight. And so they'll do like a really great job in adjusting it. And now it feels like a second skin. You know, I put it on and it's funny because I feel like cozy and warm and happy, you know, and like, oh, I'm totally protected, kind of like a turtle. And then I look in the mirror and I'm like, oh, I'm actually terrifying. Okay, cool.
And just final questions. It's pretty much been the season of exploding heads, been a lot this year. Do you ever get used to these sort of things on seeing these things happen on set and people walking around with, you know, bits of bloodied limbs and stuff? Is it quite a bizarre place to work?
It's funny because you do get used to it, and especially in seeing, you know, the making of things, you know, it kind of demystifies them for you when you're filming and when you're doing the filming. It's like, I remember seeing Gecko's hand, you know, his second arm, and I have a recording of it, and it's just, it looks so real. And on set, I'm like, man, that's so cool, like, that's awesome. Whereas, like, pretty gory, you know, when you see it in film. I think that's like a, you know, when Lamplighter burned himself to death, I remember just like looking at that charred body and like seeing him, seeing the dude like light himself on fire in real time, like all of that super like, whoa and cool. And then especially the time that passes between, you know, finishing filming and seeing it on TV. It's like, I know these things are coming, but like you see them on TV and it's like, it still startles you. Because it's so good and so visceral and so real.
Oh, great. Cool. Totally.
1, 2, 3, hit it!
I need the power!
Power!
Give it!
1, 2, 3,
hit him, Superman!